Except for not making his own clubs, Horton Smith was golf's version of the natural. A dozen years after a friend in the Ozarks convinced him that becoming a caddy was both more interesting and lucrative than herding cattle and milking cows, he was hired as the head professional at Oak Park Country Club. It was early in 1932. He was 23, after he had already won 14 times from Catalina Island to the outskirts of Paris, France, and played on a Ryder Cup team at age 20. In the 7 years he lived in Oak Park, four as the professional at Oak Park Country Club and three more after he was made an honorary member, having rejoined the tour full time, Smith won 13 times, about 41% of his tour titles. Two of those 13 victories are well remembered even today, as they came in Augusta, Georgia, in the first and third playings of the Masters. Bob Jones didn't want it called that, so the program and tickets said Augusta National Invitation Tournament. But whatever you call it, as the galleries watched Jones's return to tournament play 4 years after his Grand Slam, Smith displayed the brilliant form that brought him more victories at the start of his career than any player to that point, with only Tiger Woods surpassing his exploits in that regard. You look back on it, and it's remarkable. He began to caddy at Springfield Country Club in Missouri as an 11-year-old. A year later, he started to play. At 15, with his parents' club members, he was the club champion. 2 years later, having lowered the record of the very short course to 58, he was an assistant pro there. At 19, he qualified for the 1927 U.S. Open and finished 44th at Oakmont. He liked that first taste of big-time golf, and a year later, liked even more landing in the winner's circle in the Oklahoma City Open. He won $1,000 and said, "It looked like a million to me." At the end of 1928, he beat Walter Hagen at Catalina, won in Pensacola in February of 1929, and then swept the month of March, winning four times and jumping onto the Ryder Cup team. The hottest player in golf, nicknamed the Joplin Ghost, led the money list in 1929, winning about $15,500. But the grind, a stern practice regimen, and a 100 exhibition tour with Hagen through the Orient took a toll. Back trouble flared, but one 1930 victory was special. He won the Savannah Open by a stroke over Bob Jones, the only pro to beat Bobby in his Grand Slam year. A year later, tournaments becoming fewer in the start of the Great Depression, Smith began the search for a club job. It led to Oak Park, giving the West Suburban Club a name player to match other clubs. He would fit equipment, give lessons, sell clothing, and play with members. Every Wednesday, he'd join three members for a game. Members clamored to play with this genial fellow with the silky swing and the deadly putting touch.
Horton was only in his mid-20s when he came here. And we actually were, I think, a little bit lucky because I believe it was really kind of an injury which put him into the mode of being a club professional rather than a playing professional. And fortunately, I think for him in golf, he healed while he was here. And as his playing career took off again, then he took off on the tour.
Smith did more than sell and teach and play. He involved himself in PGA business. At 26, he was the Illinois Section President in 1935. He only left Oak Park because he married the daughter of one of Augusta National's co-founders, the heiress to the Singer sewing machine fortune. Estates in Augusta and Connecticut would be home, at least until they split and Smith went back to work, landing softly at Detroit Golf Club. He would eventually become president of the PGA of America and began the long and tortured march toward the organization's repealing the Caucasian-only membership clause.
I think two things stand out about Horton. First was that when he left here in the mid-30s, the membership elected him an honorary member, which was not something that was very common. And it's a tribute to who he was as a person. And he showed that again later in 1952 when he was president of the PGA. And he sponsored Joe Louis and two other African Americans to play in the Open despite the fact that the PGA had a Caucasians-only rule at the time. And it was only more than a decade later that that rule was repealed. So this was a man who not only was of great personal integrity, but ahead of his time as well. We at Oak Park are proud to have been associated with him.
His work for continuing education of professionals prompted the PGA to name their award for excellence in that category the Horton Smith Award. Horton Smith was 49 when he was diagnosed with lung cancer. He died 6 years later at 55. Said British great Henry Cotton, who played with Smith in World War II charity matches, "Golfers of today in America do not give him quite the place he earned.